Hi, everyone. Welcome to our virtual concert from San Francisco. I'm Mark Hanson. I will start out with a number of guitar instrumentals, and then my beautiful wife, Greta Pedersen, will join me for some vocals in the middle of the set. And I'll start out with my arrangement of Nora Jones' Don't Know Why. Hooray! Thunderous applause. Thank you very much. My playing partner up here in Portland, Oregon, where we are, Terry Robb, the Hall of Fame blues player, emailed me sometime last fall and said, Mark, I did a live show in front of an audience, and I heard applause, and it confused me. I didn't know what it was. So anyway, so I assume that you enjoyed that and you're applauding. So thank you very much. We live for that, of course, you know. Okay, I'll start, let's see. I started out with Nora Jones, an arrangement of mine that is on my Love Songs CD. And actually, that one is also in my book called Relaxing Songs for Fingerstyle Guitar. So a lot of you are listeners, not players. And I hope I will make you happy tonight. And a lot of you are players, however. And if you're interested in playing some of the things that I play tonight, I certainly have published many of them. So we'll find them for you. Okay, this one is one of my attempts to write a standard finger-picking piece in the key of A minor. There are several. There's Angie, that Paul Simon helped make famous. There's classical jazz. And there's all kinds of things. There's this. Sorry. So I thought, okay. And there's Windy and Warm. I can't forget Chet. So there are several that are in the finger-picking world very well known. So I thought I would try to write one that would also become a standard in A minor. This is one of two that I hope to play tonight. Neither one has become a standard yet, but there's still time. This one's called Easy Virtue. Is over here waiting, doing this. Thank you very much. Okay, so my set will be a combination of arrangements of mine. I love arranging, especially jazz tunes. I'll do several of those tonight. Sorry? And compositions of mine. This one is a fairly recent composition. That I wrote for the 30th anniversary edition of my book, The Art of Solo Fingerpicking, which is this one. Beautiful cover. And that book has been out since 1988. Been at this a long time, I guess. And four of the tunes in it were in need of replacing, I thought, getting a little long in the tooth. So I wrote three new ones and arranged a fourth and replaced it and put out our 30th anniversary edition a year or two ago. And this one is in drop D tuning. I call it Castaway. And it's not one word, castaway, like Tom Hanks, but cast away, as in having something and tossing it, getting rid of an old tune and writing a new one and inserting it. That's where the title comes from. It goes like this. Castaway. Thank you, Greta. And if you would like to donate to the cause, to Guitar Solo, the wonderful store in San Francisco on Townsend, and my old friend Dean Kamai, who owns it, and my new friend Sung Lin, who is helping out here, you can go to PayPal or Venmo at GSP for Guitar Solo Publications at gspguitar.com and make your contribution. And it can be any amount you like, $20 like a regular ticket, or $150 like the James Taylor tickets that are coming up, or anything in between, or less, whatever you like. Okay, I said that I play lots of jazz tunes, so I'd like to play one for you now. This is an arrangement of a tune called Angel Eyes, made famous by many singers, including, and perhaps most notably, Frank Sinatra. And you may make sure we're in tune. It always sounds best when we're in tune. Angel Eyes. Angel Eyes. Okay, I'm going to switch guitars here for a moment, and I'm going to pull out my resonator, a National. So, Dean, tell a joke. Just joking. I'm pretty quick. Okay, so there's no pickup in this, so I'll aim the microphone down at it. And we did settings earlier with a sound check and got it to sound pretty good. So here we go. It's about where we headed. Okay, this is a National resonator guitar three is a tricone, so there are three little resonators in the body, designed largely for people to be heard singing and playing on street corners. More or less concurrent with the advent of amplifiers and electric guitars, maybe a little bit before that. This is an instrumental of mine I call Grease Monkey. Sounds like this. That was fun. Guess my heart pumping, I can feel it. Cool, okay, I'm gonna do a medley, two more tunes, and then I will invite my lovely wife Greta up, and she's going to sing several songs with me. I was gonna say for me, well, that too. So, this is a medley. The first one I call Riff Raff, a little kind of bluesy throwaway in the key of E, not a throwaway, but fun tune. And I segue that into a tune from 1932, which I think you'll recognize. And in the midst of that, I have two other tunes that are somewhat disguised. See if you can ferret them out when they arrive. Here's Riff Raff. Thank you. Thank you. And would you please welcome my lovely wife, Greta Pedersen. Greta and I played nightclubs decades ago, 4 or 5 nights a week, prior to having our two daughters, our wonderful daughters who are watching tonight. Thank you very much. And in addition to that, she had a children's music company, and she made a couple of recordings. Here's one right here, Music is Magic, which you can find at greta.com.
And also,
.net, excuse me, Greta at greta.net. And she was Young Audience's National Artist of the Year in 2009. I do believe.
That's yes. Right.
So, just thrilled to be married. Thrilled to be married to a champion. It's really great.
I was going to say right after your Grammy.
Oh yes, after we won a Grammy in 2005, right? So.
All right. Oh, do you want to talk about this?
The ukulele. This ukulele is from Woodley White. Woodley lived in Portland for a long time. He and his wife moved to the Big Island and are making classical guitars and ukuleles. We commissioned him to make a baritone ukulele for us, so he made it out of koa and abalone inlay. It's beautiful, and it's just a killer. It is so loud, this instrument, that we had to turn my guitar up to compete. But we're going to have Greta play this wonderful instrument and sing you a very fun song, a little comic relief after that last one. So here we go.
Okay, here we go. 2, 3. I never cared much for moonlit skies. I never winked back at fireflies. But now that the stars are in your eyes, I'm beginning to see the light. I never went in for afterglow or candlelight on the mistletoe. But now that you've turned the lights down low, I'm beginning to see the light. Used to ramble through the park, shadow boxing in the dark. Then you came and caused a spark that's a full on fire now. I never made love by lantern shine. I never found rainbows in my wine. But now that your lips are burning mine, I'm beginning to see the light. Jazz hands for me. Thank you, Mark.
Good work, Greta.
What happened to my drum?
I was on your behind the left. Okay. The priest tool on the left.
So we have played many, many weddings over the years, and some of the most fun have been for our
nieces and nephews that have gotten married through the year. In fact, I understand at least one of them was watching tonight.
Okay.
Leave and Tamur and their three daughters. That'll be fun. So this is a song that we learned for another niece. Sorry, Leave. They're all good songs. This is an interesting one that we weren't really sure about at first. It starts out, the book of love is long and boring. No one can lift the damn thing. And the song grew on us so much that we recorded it in a CD that we recorded a few years ago. Mark was going to hold it up then and now. You can see a picture of us on the front. And then a picture of us from a few years ago. We had fun putting that one together.
We did.
Anyway. So this is a song from
Magnetic
Field called The Book of Love.
And Peter Gabriel had a nice version of this as well.
Okay. The Book of Love is long and boring. No one can lift the damn thing. It's full of charts and facts and figures and instructions for dancing. But I love it when you read to me and you could read me anything. The Book of Love has music in it. In fact, that's where music comes from. Some of it is just transcendental. Some of it is just really dumb. But I love it when you sing to me and you sing me anything.
You could give me a wedding ring.
Lovely. That's Greta.
Oh, well, thank you.
Oh, thank you. Yes, donations are accepted via PayPal and Venmo at Guitar Solo Publications, GSP, at gspguitar.com. And if you'd like to find my materials, I've written many, many books. Here's another one, Great American Songbook. Angel Eyes is in this, along with many other jazz standards. You could look at my website, which is markhansonguitar.com. Pretty easy to remember. And Hanson is S-O-N, not S-E-N.
I see we have some chats there, and unfortunately, it's too small for us to read. So thank you for sending us messages, and we will look them up and respond to them later. Unless you can read them, Mark. I can't. Can you?
I can. And Paul Montgomery got all the tunes, the hidden tunes, in my arrangement of Brother Can You Spare a Dime?
He did?
Yes. He got them. He says, Brother Can You Spare a Dime, When Johnny Comes Marching Home Again. Yes. And the other one was The Star-Spangled Banner, but in a minor key.
Can you play it for them?
Yeah, let me take the capo off or I'll be confused. Recognize it now? So anyway, okay, and moving on, we are now going to do a tune from, we got from the singing of the Reverend Gary Davis. If you haven't heard of him, you should look him up. He was a street corner singer, started out in the Deep South, wound up in New York City, was guitar teacher to many finger-picking blues players of my generation.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, sure. And we got this song from his singing.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And it's called
Keep Your Lamps Trimmed.
Keep Your Lamps Trimmed and Burning.
Don't you worry.
Thanks for having me, Mark.
Yes.
Thanks. Enjoy the rest of the concert, folks. And thanks for listening.
Big round of applause for Greta. Thank you. Okay. Well, this is being broadcast from San Francisco. I lived in the San Francisco Bay Area for 25 years of my life and spent a fair amount of time in San Francisco. Certainly was there when Jerry Garcia and the Grateful Dead were making a big name for themselves. And perhaps you have noticed my tie. This is one of my collection of Jerry Garcia ties. I like them. Okay, and I said I would play another tune in A minor that I composed before the other one, hoping that it would become a fingerstyle standard. And it's still working at that. That's good. I call it Key to the Kingdom. And it's become something of a signature piece for me. In the Travis picking style, alternating bass. Although I don't mute the bass strings on this one. Here we go, Key to the Kingdom. Key to the Kingdom. Having grown up in an era where we tuned our guitars with our ears, living through the era now where we tune them with our eyes, is an interesting change. OK, convenient if you're in a noisy place playing in a bar. You have to tune with your eyes. But I tell my students, boy, you have to train your ears. It's all about how it sounds. So, okay, I'll do a couple more. What have I got here? How about this one? Georgia. Thank you. Okay, well, once again, thank you, a huge thank you to Dean Kamai and his whole crew at Guitar Solo on Townsend in San Francisco for hosting these. Thank you to Greta for adding her wonderful voice and musicianship to our show here. And again, if you feel inclined to make a donation, you can go on PayPal or Venmo at gsp@gspguitar.com. And I'm going to do one more tune. I have a lot of choices, but you know, in memory of Jerry Garcia, I'm going to do a little short version here of Ripple. I loved those acoustic albums they did about 1970, Uncle Dan's Band, Working Man's Dead, and American Rose, American Beauty albums. And this was kind of a children's anthem for him. He had a children's chorus singing at the end. And it's actually in my relaxing songs book, an arrangement in the key of C that's quite playable. I'll do the one in the key of G. So again, thank you very much for listening, for tuning in, and I hope there were no vagaries of the internet with the audio and the visual arriving at different times. I've seen that, and there are all kinds of things that happen, but hopefully it went well. Thank you. Here we go, Ripple. Sing along if you know the words. Thank you once again for tuning in. We'll see you again. Thanks. And go to PayPal.